everyone. How are we doing tonight? Some of you said and sounded like you meant it. I heard, good. How are we doing tonight? Oh, that's a little bit better. I'm going to do it one more time. How are we doing tonight? Yeah, that was everybody tonight. That's awesome. Well, of course, my name is Miss Katie. I am not Mr. Scott. He is not here. Nowhere to be found in the building. So we're going to have a great time anyway. Amen? Now, I was just talking to some of you, and it looks like that, you know, we just got through with the Christmas production. And some of you were not here when we were talking about Christmas. So this is our last lesson on Christmas before we get into the new year. So we're going to kind of walk through some things so that you'll be caught up, okay? But first we're going to pray. Amen? All right, Father, thank you so much for this time together tonight. We're excited to know that you are with us and that we're in a time where you are always watching out for us. And so, Father, I thank you. We give this class over to you. Thank you for the hearts that are open. Thank you, Father, they have ears to hear. And we just want to know that the Spirit of God is talking to us so that we can be obedient and do what he says. And everybody said, amen. Well, first of all, I want to go over the expectations. And they begin with the letter E, right? No, you're shaking your head. It's supposed to go like this. No, it's not E. Micah, isn't it E? The expectations? What letter is it? An R. Okay. Well, who can give me an expectation one that begins with an R? Remain in your seat. That's a good expectation. What's another one? Remain what? Yes. And then what are we supposed to do also with that? Remain quiet and what? Well, that's respect, but there's another part to So you remain quiet when the teacher's talking. You're also staying in your seat, but you also need to raise your hand. And then the last one is a totally different word altogether. That word is respect, right? So you respect who? Your neighbor, right? So you respect your neighbor. You don't sit too close, but yet, you know, you don't sit too far away, you know. So those are good expectations. But I need to make another letter, don't I? It's not E, Katie. It's R, right? I'm glad you guys knew. I'll tell Mr. Scott you kept me straight. Amen? Amen. So now we're going to do the offering, and we're going to pray over the offering, and then once the music starts, you just come up. The white bucket is here. I know I got buckets on the stage down here, but the little white bucket here and the white bucket there, okay? So hold your offering up to the Lord. You got it yet? We'll wait. It's okay. All right. Let's say this together. It's always good to have a confession of faith. Amen? Say, Father God, I give you my offering. I ask you to use it to build your kingdom. And I thank you in advance for what you're going to do so you can give it to me so I can sow it into others. In Jesus' name, amen. So once you hear the music, you can bring up your offering. Good. Thank you, Lord. All right, so you see this table up here. Mr. Scott put these tables out, and he did a really good job about a timeline. Because did you know, how many of you know that before Jesus was ever even brought to the earth, there were people that were saying, he's coming. Who's coming? Well, Jesus is coming. That was our first week that we wanted to let you know that before you could even imagine, we're talking thousands of years, 1,000 years, which is what we have down here. We have actually, we started with King David. Remember King David, when he was young, there was a prophet that prophesied and came and anointed him saying, you're going to be king. Wow. Can you imagine as a young man, a teenager, somebody speaking over your life saying, when you grow up, you're going to be? Wow. So we see that Jesus came from the house of David. Amen. And then we also see in the Bible how God used these other prophets. Everybody say prophets. Now, prophets in the Old Testament spoke things in the earth. And God needed the prophets to speak it so that it would come to pass. So they listened to what God said, and they were speaking what the prophet was speaking, what was going to happen long before it did. But as you see, the numbers get smaller. Why? Because we're headed to the birth. So whenever anybody was put in the earth, then the time got shorter as to when it was going to happen. Amen? You follow me? So let's say some of these folks. Everybody say Hosea, Jeremiah, Zephaniah, and Isaiah. No, I'm sorry. I'm reading upside down. Zechariah, right. This is Jeremiah. Let's get it right. Amen? So these were prophets that we know that were speaking different things so that Jesus could come to earth. Amen? Now, we see here Micah is even closer to when Christ was about ready to be born. Amen? So that's what we kind of went over our first week. And we're going to pause there so that we can have Miss Sydney come up and do our praise and worship. And then we will talk a little bit more about what we learn, because after all, Jesus is coming.
Oh, want to love you more than before. I want to worship deeper than before. I got to scream louder. Yeah. Come on and say, freedom, freedom, oh Lord, freedom. Yeah. Freedom.
No matter what I'm facing, no matter what I've done, staring at a mountain, a giant that comes, oh, I will pray. Lord, I will pray to you.
That was really good. You guys really worshiped. That's good. Because, you know, when we lift our heart to the Lord, then we are actually inviting Him in. Amen? Now, I came up here to the Nativity because I see we have some other folks. I have five pieces that are out here, and I think there's seven children. So I want to put two more pieces out. And I'm who wants to help me? Okay, but if you're going to help me, you can guys can have a seat. If you're going to help me, you have to obey your mom or your dad that's in the room, okay? So, I think what I'm going to do is take the camel as piece number 6. And then I'm going to take the sheep, the big sheep, as piece number 7. And I'm going to put it down here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces. And I'm going to point to who's going to help me. 1, I'll leave you out, Mom. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so Mom, can you help him if I get an 8? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's do a second wise man, okay? But this is what we're going to do. We're going to take them in order, okay? So that way, it'll go a little bit faster, okay? Because we don't want to spend a lot of time. But I want you to know, this was our second week where we talked about Jesus is here. We had a package that was coming. We heard. The prophet spoke. Everybody was expecting a package to be delivered. And it was Christ the Lord. And the second week, we saw that Jesus came. And he told the world that something special had happened. Guess how he did it? Everybody say the star. Yeah. Who knows who saw the star? Who were the different people that saw the star? The wise men was one, yes. The shepherds, who else? The what? The sheep? Yeah. Hey, yes, absolutely. And, you know, the shepherds were keeping the sheep, but I tell you what, when that star was shining bright in the sky and came over those sheep, what do you think they said? Bah, bah, there's something happening. And they let the shepherds know something was happening. So who's going to be, all right, let's start here with first. Come on up, pick the first angel. And I'd like for you to put that angel right here in front of the tree. There you go. Turn it this way, kind of, because after all, it's all about the baby, right? It's all about the baby. Next. Big ram. The sheep. You can put that sheep right there in front of the bale of hay. There you go. All right. Next. You got one of the shepherds. Put that right here. Actually, save room for the one of the wise men. Yeah. Okay. How about you, Miss? Ready? You've got the wise men next. Put him right there, because see the spot? Oh, you did it so great. Oh, I can't touch it. I wish I could. We're going to have a time where we're going to be able to hug each other, give high fives, and it's going to be wonderful. Amen? Okay. All right, so we're up to the next shepherd. I'll let the elders. Okay, that shepherd, we're going to put over here. Okay. All right. Next on the end, we got another angel. Wow, Jesus had a lot of angels helping him to get everybody to the place. Let's put that angel here. Okay, there we go. All right, now Miss Yukita gets to do a wise man. Look, you get to do a wise man. Oh, yep, say I'm going to need to have your help. Put the wise man right here. Okay, right there. Awesome. Great job. And I still have one more. Oh, yes. Can't forget the youth of America. You can put the camel. We'll put the camel right here. Amen. So boys and girls, let's give Jesus a hand clap, right? All these people, we've got the shepherds, we got the wise men, we've got the animals, all came because they wanted to witness this big event. It meant something to them. They knew this special package was here, right? Okay, so I'm going to go up on the stage now. Hallelujah. And I want to, so the first week was Jesus is coming. The second week was Jesus is here. We've put the nativity together and remember, well, no, you don't remember because you were doing the Christmas play. In the meantime of that second week, we got a very special package that was delivered. And you know what that package was? It was God's word. When Jesus was born, that was God placing in the earth his word. Now, when you go to your Bible today and when you open God's word, it gives you a light to what God really wants and means for you to have in your life. Guess where you find that? In God's word. The Holy Bible illuminates. Do you know what illuminate means? It means it brightens up your understanding. So whenever you have a question about something, whenever you have a problem that you're dealing with, guess what? Go to God's word and say, Lord, would you shine some light on this problem I have? Would you shine some light on these questions that I have? Would you help me, Lord? And guess what, boys and girls? You will. Amen? So that's what we learned on the second week, how God was placed in the earth. Amen? Now, for this week, tonight, what we're going to be talking about is how Jesus is with us. See, he was a baby, but did he stay a baby? Everybody say, no. Mm-mm. He did not stay a baby. He grew up just like you're growing up. How many of you are taller than you were when you were six? How many of you are taller than you were when you were four? See, you grow into a bigger height when you come to every year. You get older, you get wiser, you get more input in. Amen? So, let's put up our memory verse for tonight, which is 2 Corinthians 5:17. Everybody say 2 Corinthians 5:17. And read that with me. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. The old is gone, and the new has come. Amen, amen. Now, 2 Corinthians 5:17. That is right. So, when Jesus came, he gave us new life. Everybody say, new life. Now, I have a question for you. You may not know it, but also during these weeks, so those of you that are not here, we had a very special animal, and that animal is a part of our nativity, but there was a very special animal that came and visited with us every week and shared with us and helped us get to the package that was being delivered. So if we could go back to where that special animal was, and guess what that animal was? It was the donkey. The donkey that brought Mary and Joseph, but he carried Mary, to the special place where the star was. And the donkey, he was so excited the first week because he knew something was happening. The animals were talking. All the talk around town that there was people coming into the town. And that's because everybody had to go there to get taxed, right? To be counted, to make sure that they were still living in the town. Then once the baby was born, they had to make room for him in the stable, which was one of his stalls. He had to get cleared out. So I wonder what's going to happen this week. So let's see if we can visit with him and find out what's going to happen.
Yeehaw, 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 yeehaw. I'm so excited. Yeehaw, yeehaw. I'm so excited.
What are you so excited about?
Oh, guess what?
What?
What? No, I overheard the innkeeper talking to Joseph. You know, Joseph and Mary.
Yes, what were they talking about?
Well, they were talking about using me. He asked, Joseph was asking the innkeeper, can he use me to go on a trip with him, you know? Take me on a trip.
You were going to go on a journey?
Yeah, he was asking the innkeeper if I could go with him. You know, that sounds pretty cool.
Well, how soon are you going to go?
I mean, oh, I'm soon right now. We're going to go someplace special. You want to know where?
Somewhere special?
Yeah.
Where on earth would you be going this time of year?
Well, I heard them talk about going to Egypt.
Egypt?
Egypt. Yeah.
Wow. I mean, hey, look, you just got here. I mean, Joseph and Mary just got here. The baby was just born, and now you're talking about going to Egypt?
Yeah. You know, I heard that something, this dream or something, God was talking to Joseph and said he had to go to Egypt, you know. So he heard us talking to God. God said, go to Egypt. And guess what?
What?
Are you ready? He's going to take me. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
I'm so excited. I want to go to Egypt and see the pyramids. You see the river, the Nile, and all those kind of cool things that you see in Egypt.
That's a long journey.
Yeah, but it's going to be great, you know.
Mr. Donkey, that's a long journey. I mean, well, I know you're going to do a good job.
Yeah.
I know they can count on you to get them to Egypt.
I'm so happy too because God's going to use me. It feels good to be used. You know, wow. I have a purpose in life. You know, I get to do something for the baby Jesus. That's so cool.
It is cool.
Well, I'm going to go get some more food. Going to eat up, get stocked up with the water.
Well, from the way you look, you might want to eat some more food and store up your strength because you've got a long road ahead of you.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Bye.
Wow, that's something, boys and girls. So the donkey sounds like he just got into town, just worked with all of the animals to make sure that he got everything in place. And now it looks like he's going to be going on a journey that's going to take him far. Everybody say far. Far away. So what I want to do now is, if you notice on the edge of the stage here, I have these clappers. Everybody say clappers. Now I will tell you from the beginning, they are not really durable, so you have to be delicate with them, but yet they will make noise. Hear it? So I'd like for you to get up one at a time. You can start over here, and you can pick one, please. Any color you can pick. All right. You can get one, Mom. Okay. Mom, you can get one, too, if you want. Yeah, Mike, get your mom. So we're going to do a little exercise because, you know, next, come on up and get one. Pick one quick. Next. Can you, okay. You know, boys and girls, sometimes it's really good to know how to express joy and to express gratitude. To be thankful about things because, you know, it can slip by and gratitude can sneak up on you. That means not being grateful. And we want to be grateful. Amen? So what I want to do is we want to use clapping hands. Now, why do you clap? Tell me, why do you clap? It's to celebrate, right? So when you clap, that means you're happy. I mean, you wouldn't clap because of something bad happened, right? No. You clap because you're happy and you're joyful, and that fills your heart with joy. And so that's why we want to remind ourselves. See, you have to remind yourself. You can't go by your feelings. You have to remind yourself that God has done great things. And guess who he did them for? You. Put your finger right here and say, God has done great things just for me. And I'm grateful. Amen. So what we're going to do is, I have this scripture, and I went to what we call the Message Bible, and it kind of takes verses and writes it in like everyday language, okay? So Colossians 3, 1 through 4 says, so if you are serious about living this new resurrected life with Christ, act like it. You know, it's kind of like saying, if you're happy and you know it, put a smile on your face. Let somebody see that smile come out. Actually, the song goes, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Let's use these. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Right? So, we're to act like it, okay? So, if God is your Lord and Savior, if God is someone that you love, then act like you love him. You can't hide your love from God, amen? That wouldn't be cool. What if your friend who you liked and want to hang out with, inviting your best friend over to your house to spend the night, having hot chocolate, popping some popcorn, looking at movies. Isn't that grand? Isn't that cool? You're hanging out with them. But what if you invited them over and you were in your room all night and they were in the living room? Would that be good? Do you think they'd come back? No. So when we hang with the Lord, then we want to make sure that we act like we want to be with God and that we're not ashamed of God, right? Okay, so we act like it. It also says, go after life itself like Christ does. He went after life wholeheartedly. And whenever he saw someone that was hurting, he helped them and he did what the Father told him to do. Amen? Don't shuffle along, eyes to the ground, like you don't have a friend in the world. Who would want to be around you if you acted that way? Nobody, right? That old life is gone, and Christ has given you a new life. Amen? So how many of you believe that Christ has given you a new life? Let's clap our hands. How many of you feel like that Christ is your friend? Okay, all right. How many of you feel that he is coming back one day? Ooh, yeah. That is going to be the best day. Amen? Amen. So it's going to be good to know that when you love the Lord, you need to act like it and show it to others. Amen? So when we clap our hands, we're clapping to let others know that we are joyful and grateful. Everybody say, I'm joyful and I'm grateful. And see, what you want to see is you want to see more of this on your face and less of this. Because frowns tell people, I don't want you around me. But smiles say, come on, let's hang together. Amen? Amen. So, glory to God. Hallelujah. All right, so let's put our clappers in our pockets, please. No more clapping for right now, okay? And what we're going to do next is we're going to have Mr. Paul, who is coming up. He is going to share a story. And we are going to let him do that. Amen?
Amen. So hello, hello. Praise the Lord. Everybody excited? Yeah, this is the beginning of a new year coming up, right? Everybody excited about New Year? All right. Well, one thing that's exciting to me, and I think it would be fun if we did this, wouldn't it be kind of cool if we could go back and walk the earth with Jesus? You know, like walk along where he's going, listen to what he's saying. So let's do the Bible story tonight, is to kind of go over some things as we walk with Jesus in his day-to-day routine. Does that sound like fun? Imagine now, but I'm thinking, I'm going to go back. I'm going to be walking with Jesus. Now, am I going to be driving a car? No, no. What am I going to be doing? Walking, exactly. He's going to be walking everywhere I go. So anyway, Jesus and his friends and disciples would walk all over the place, and sometimes they would go into next country. We got that. Good. So sometimes he would go into another country. Sometimes he would go here, go there. But when you see people today, real famous people, what happens when famous people go out in the streets and stuff? Do they get, no one says hello, nothing? Well, a lot of times, a lot of people gather around them, right? They crush them in there. They all start gathering. Oh, guess what? So even back today, Jesus is here. He's here. Jesus is here. And so they'd all go and run and find out where Jesus was. And so Jesus would preach and share with all good things that God had for them, share God's plan, and he would tell them the good news of what God has got going for each person and how they do it. Plus, he would lay hands on people, they'd be healed. And this would go on all time, all kinds of people crowded around. So guess what? Just like today, there are people who are trying to do the crowd control. No, not you can't go see Jesus now. Line up over here, go over here. You know, so So they would try to keep people coming and going. And one thing they didn't want to do, they always wanted just the adults. They didn't want no children coming in over there. No, no, they wanted the adults to come over there. In fact, they even were thinking and asked Jesus, who's the greatest person? Who would be the greatest in the kingdom of God? And Jesus said, oh, what do you think Jesus said? He said, you know what? People who humble themselves and become like a child, those people are the ones that God will hear and listen to because they are humble, okay? So Jesus said, bring those children to me. Bring them on over here. Let me talk to them. Let me bless them. Let me pray for them. Let me heal them, right? So Jesus told his friends and people, bring the children. I want to be with the children, not just the adults. So Jesus would have them maybe come on his lap and tell them stories just like he told the adults. So it's pretty cool. Next thing. So as Jesus walked around, sometimes he would go to different countries. You know, he'd walk forever. And so one of the countries that he went to was called Samaria. And after walking for so long, he got tired. He probably got hungry. So his disciples and friends, they were probably off going looking for food and all that stuff. So he sat down by a well. And guess what? While he was sitting there, a sad, lonely woman came to the well. Now, normally when they go to the well, most of the time they would go in groups of people. It's safer that way. They'd have their friends, so maybe a couple neighbor ladies and stuff, they would all go together to go get some water or the husbands or something. Whoever was gathering the water, they'd usually be in with more people. But no, she doesn't have anybody with her. She's all by herself. You know why? The people in the village, she had done things and did stuff that they didn't like. She wasn't well thought of. She didn't have any friends. She was real lonely. She didn't have any friends. And so she had to go get water all by herself. When everybody was gone, then she could go get the water. So when she saw Jesus there, he asked her, Jesus is going to be friendly. But you know why Jesus is going to be friendly? He asked her for water. But she said, well, you wouldn't talk to me. You don't know who I am. I'm like your enemy. Our people are your people's enemies. So if you know that, you wouldn't be talking to me. But Jesus said, I know more than that. I know all kinds of things about what you do and what your life is all about. In fact, if you knew who I was, Jesus says, we know who I was, guess what? You would ask for living water. Living water, that don't make sense. So Jesus was talking to her and sharing stuff, and Jesus started telling her all kinds of stuff that she had done in her life. Now, how would Jesus know this lady? He just met her. He doesn't know what she did, but he does know because God knows all about us. He knows what's in our heart. He knows what we've done. You can't hide things from the Lord, all right? So Jesus started telling her stuff, but then as he told her about the living water, all of a sudden she had one of those aha moments. She realized that she was talking to the Messiah. Now, again, remember, we've been talking about promises that God gave us. So all these people from all over their area were promised, were looking for the Messiah to come. She realized this Jesus was the Messiah. She got so excited and all kinds of stuff. And she believed that Jesus was the Messiah. Next slide. So she did. She ran back to the village. She started telling everybody about Jesus. And that's kind of how we are. When we get Jesus in our heart, when we get excited for Jesus, we got to tell people about it. We want to tell, let me tell you what Jesus did for me. Let me tell you what Jesus can do for you. So she told all the village people, come. You got to hear this man. He's the Messiah. He told me all kinds of stuff. So all the people in the village went to see this man, and they believed, many believed that he was the Messiah. And they listened to everything he had. It was real exciting. And so many people believed in Jesus that day, and they lived there. They stayed there for a day or two and talked more about the Lord. Okay, next slide. Next picture. Now, after all that work, they got so tired. Jesus is working all the time. So one day after working all day, praying for people, healing people, walking for all over the long distance, Jesus, everybody was so tired, and they had to go someplace on the other side of a lake, a sea. Excuse me. So They all got in the boat. Again, Jesus was so tired. Can you imagine how tired I was walking all over the place? So Jesus did what? He fell asleep. He laid down on the boat, fell asleep. What do you think? You think Jesus snored? Let me hear some snoring. You think Jesus snored? Probably not. But while Jesus was sleeping, guess what happened? All of a sudden a huge monster storm came in off the water, came in on the sea, dark cloud, rain and thunder. Hear me, hear some thundering. All kinds of rain, all kinds of thunder, lightning and stuff, and the boat is gonna look like the boat was gonna sink, and the boat was full of water, and the people were just scared. They were afraid they were gonna drown. They thought that boat was gonna sink, and they were all gonna be dead. And guess what Jesus is doing? He's sleeping away. Doesn't care about the storm. And they said, wake up, Jesus, wake up. We're gonna die. Oh, come on, wake up, Jesus. And he woke up. What's going on? Look at the storm, we're gonna die. Look at all the thunder, we're gonna die. And Jesus used words with faith and power. And he said, calm the storm. And guess what happened? The storm went quiet. Peace. No more storm. We have to follow the Lord. He will tell us what to say, give us the power we need when we need it. So Jesus calmed the storm, and the disciples said, wow, this man truly is the Son of God. So as they got back to their village, next one, were you the village? All right, when they got back, I can't see it very well. When they got back to the village, and there's a place called Galilee where they're living, a man came to, you remember, that was all kinds of people, right? Remember Jesus out there? Crowds and stuff like that. This man named Jairus wanted to talk to Jesus, and he had to talk to him right now. He probably had to fight his way through the crowd. You know, you can imagine all these people all swarming around him. Yeah, you try, excuse me, I need to talk to Jesus, excuse me, sorry, I didn't mean to step on your toe, excuse me. He had to work his way up to get to Jesus. He had to get Jesus now. What happened was his daughter was dying at their house. He wanted Jesus to believe and to heal his daughter. And everybody was saying, oh, she's dead. Jesus said, do you believe that she can be healed? She believes she's alive? And the man said, I believe. So this man, and Jesus started walking to his house so they can pray for his daughter. And on the way to their house, people were running up, go back, too late, she's dead. No point coming to the house no more. She's dead. Your daughter's dead. But Jesus said, do you believe she's alive? And he believed. So when they got to the house, all these people were crying. Because the girl died. They said she's dead. They were crying and screaming. Oh. But Jesus said, all you people, get out of here. Get out of here. Because they didn't believe that she was alive. But Jesus and that man believed. So Jesus prayed for her, and Jesus touched her, and she rose up again, and she was all healed and just fine. It was so great. So there was rejoicing, all because Jesus healed her. And guess what? Jesus can heal us today too. We use our faith like the man uses his faith and trust the Lord that he will heal us, and we are healed in Jesus' name, see? All right, next slide. All right, so today What I want to make sure you know is that even today, Jesus wants to be with us. He wants us to spend time with him. He wants to get us to know him, and we want to get to know him. So when we pray and talk to Jesus, when we read the Bible, we have all kinds of exciting things that we learn and how Jesus wants us to do things. And it's just a wonderful time that Jesus is alive today. He's resurrected with the power of God, and he wants to spend time with us. And one way we can spend time with Jesus is by praying. So remember, when you go home, when you're walking around or you're at school, it doesn't matter what day or time it is, you can talk to the Lord. Just start talking to him and thank him and whatever you need to say. In Jesus' name, that's it.
Hallelujah. You know, that's a good story because, again, it's good for us to know that Jesus, he is always there with us and for us. Amen. So sometimes when you feel alone, guess what? You're not alone. You're never alone. No, we're always there. Amen. Yes. So, hallelujah. We want to make sure that, you know, you realize that, that, you know, Jesus is always with you and that he is always, he is always wanting you to know that, that wherever
Special
you
delivery.
Go, he goes.
Special
He's
delivery.
Not by himself.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Yes, I have a delivery for KidzTown Live class.
A delivery?
Yes, it's for KidzTown Live.
You know, wait a minute. Mr. Scott didn't tell me we were going to have a delivery.
Well, it's okay. It actually says, are you Miss Katie Lentz?
I am.
Okay, well, please, you know, it's Christmas time. I have so many packages to deliver.
Oh, okay. Okay. So can you bring it down here, so please?
Sure. Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
One's for you, and actually one's for the office, so.
A package for me.
Katie Lentz and KidzTown Live class.
Okay. Do I have to sign anything?
You do.
Okay. All right. I don't know what this is. They did not tell me that I was going to be getting...
All right, you have a blessed Christmas.
All right, can you, are you able to put that up here? Since
maybe I can get it.
Can you help me, Mr. Paul?
Oh, great. Thank you, sir.
And then the other box you said was for the office?
That's for the office.
Mine rolling.
I'll take it to
the
office.
Yeah, the office is, you know, that
okay.
way.
Thank you all.
Wait a minute. Hold it. I believe my name was on the, I signed for.
Yeah,
Well, I tell you what, you can help me. Can you help me?
Oh, I could try.
All right, so why don't you put it down there and look what I have in my pocket. Mm-hmm. Would you open it? No, wait a minute. Open the box. I wonder what it is. Mr. Scott didn't tell me. I wonder what it is. Oh, my. Okay. All right. I'll take those. Thank you. Wow, wait a minute, hold on a second. Wow, wait a minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's enough in there for Anton, for everybody here. Wow, Sydney. Can you help me? Because it looks like Mr. Paul is really getting excited about this box. So it may not make it over to the desk there. All right. So, Sydney, can you put them over there at the desk?
Make sure they just give them one.
All right. We're going to watch you. We're watching. We're watching. She's walking almost to the desk. She's there. Oh, here she comes. Putting it down. Mm-hmm. Okay. Very good. Yep. Hallelujah. Thank you, Sydney. So, you know, Mr. Scott, now he's texting me. Okay. Oh. Well, it looks like, boys and girls, that Mr. Scott thought ahead and he created some special bags for us so that we could take with us some things that would help us tell others about the Lord. So He gave me an inventory. I think there's a witnessing bracelet in there. There's a goodie in there, like a candy cane. And there's also like a track that turns into a cross. So, wow, those are cool things. And I believe 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So I believe there's 12 in there. So, Mr. Paul, if there's one left, we'll make sure you get one, right? All right, so I want us to look at these buckets. And on the buckets, we have something very special. I'm going to set these here in front of the table so you can see. We see that one has all on it. And New Year's Day detergent, all, okay? These are going to remind us of some ways that we could tell others how we belong to the Lord. This one is called Miracles Car Resurrection Soap. Ooh. We're going to get you guys involved here. Then we have one that's called Dawn. Life is New Again, Dishwashing Liquid. So can you imagine if you have these products in your home? What you could just do with telling others about the Lord. Fresh Start Soap. Wouldn't it really be interesting? Let's say, for instance, I'm going to use this one. And why don't some of you think about what these say and maybe see if we couldn't give you about 30 seconds to come up with a little jingle or advertisement. How would you use this to witness to somebody that you belong to the Lord? Think about it, okay? For instance, Fresh Start Soap. Lord, you know what? You could just say, you know what? I need a fresh start today, so I'm going to pull out my Fresh Start Soap, and it's going to wash away all the things that have prevented me from moving forward in God. All I got to do is scrub myself up, get in the shower with my Fresh Start Soap, and all of a sudden, I am fresh and new. No, not the same person. Everything that I need to fall off of me gets washed off down the drain, right? That would make you want to go buy something, wouldn't it? If you could just wash it away and make sure that it doesn't exist anymore, Fresh Start Soap. Amen?
Well, Miss Katie, that reminds me about Jesus.
Yeah.
He washed away our sins. And we got a new life.
Yeah. Because see, the old is gone, and it leaves us fresh or fresh start. I got a fresh start. Amen? So, anybody else? Who thinks they have something that they want to tell somebody about? All, for instance, New Year's Day detergent. I'm going to give it all to Jesus.
Ooh.
I give it all. Give it all away. All right, who else? Come on. This one? This one? What are you going to say? Come on up here if you want to. Yeah, she said resurrection soap. Jesus rose again from the dead. Amen. So see, when you wash with resurrection soap, you are raised to a new place in Christ. No longer are you the same on the same place. All right, come on up.
You know, Miss Katie, while these coming up there, that resurrection, that's the power. A lot of power goes into that resurrection.
Right.
A lot of power in there.
What do you think causes all the suds?
Well, the Holy Ghost is God, but guess what?
What?
We have the Holy Ghost, so we have His power to do His will.
That's right. That's right. Because, see, one of the things that we didn't bring out with the donkey, remember how the donkey said that he was getting ready to go on a journey? Well, guess who told Joseph that he needed to go away from where he was. Who did that? Who told him? The Holy Spirit, right? See, the Holy Spirit will give you instruction. Mr. Paul, the Holy Spirit will let you know when you're in trouble. And the Holy Spirit will help you get out of trouble. The Holy Spirit rescues us. So that's important, that when you are in trouble, guess what? You go after God. You don't run from God, right? Because he wants us to have access to all of his different gifts. He wants us to have access to things that will help us get better, not worse, better. Amen?
You know, that resurrection thing reminds me of this dawn.
Yeah.
New beginning, new day.
New day. What happened yesterday is gone. I've got a new day. The fresh and new has come. Did you have something? Come on up. Which one? This one? All right, what did you want to say? Jesus washed all our old stuff away so that we have new life. We have a fresh start, right? Amen. That's good.
Amen.
It's good for you to know that God is for you. He is not against you.
Amen.
That whenever you have a problem, guess who's your problem solver? Who's your problem solver? God is your problem solver. That's right. Who gives you the best solutions to your problems? Who? Jesus, the Holy Spirit. That's right. That's right. So whenever you bump into a problem in any way, then you know that life is new again, so that you can start over. You know, the devil will try to convince you, well, you've done it now. No way is God going to forgive you for that. Yes, he will. He forgives you for anything. So there is nothing that you can do that will not cause him to always come and rescue you. Amen?
Amen.
He's already done it on the cross. Right? Right. So amen, amen, and amen. Anybody else? Got
amen.
Anything else? Help me out. Yes. Come on up. What did you want to say? Which one? Yep, you like that too? What are you going to say? With fresh and new. Fresh start soap. Another chance. Yes, absolutely. Give me an
Amen.
Air five.
Amen.
Give me that's an air five. Yeah, that's good. See, we have another chance, Mr. Paul.
Amen.
God gives us another chance. That is excellent. Yes. Because see, so many times we feel like that we keep bumping into the same old stuff. And God doesn't want that. He wants to relieve us of all the old stuff. As a matter of fact, he did. That's why he sent Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So everybody say, out with the old.
Out with the old.
In with the new.
In with the new.
Amen?
Amen.
All right. So, see, when you ask for forgiveness, guess who forgives? God does. That's right. And he doesn't think anything about it. It's already in the package, so to speak. So when you ask forgiveness, that's a part of your salvation.
Amen.
Right? When you get saved, when God comes into your heart, when he's with you and being your best friend, there's nothing that you can do that would keep him from coming to your rescue, from making you feel better, not worse. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, praise God. I believe we ought to pray. Let's stand to our feet.
Hallelujah.
And let's pray. We've had a great night here tonight. Have you all enjoyed the lesson? If you have, let's clap our hands. Amen. I've enjoyed it. Amen. Yeah, you enjoyed it. Amen. So tonight when you go, what we want you to do is we want you to take a bag, Sydney and Miss Carol are going to be about to just take one at a time. And Yurkita, even the young one can have one too. And you, adults included, okay?
Uh-huh.
Amen. Let's say this together. Say, Father, I am so grateful.
I am so grateful.
That you sent Jesus.
That you sent Jesus.
Just for me.
Just for me.
I receive him.
I receive him.
As my Lord and Savior.
My Lord and Savior.
And I declare.
And I declare.
That this new year.
That this new year.
Will be different for me.
Will be different.
Because I have Jesus as my friend. He will be close more than he ever has. Because I decide to put him in everything. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, everybody, please wait for the attendants to release you. Go out the door here. God bless you. Happy New Year. Be safe, and we'll see you next time.